So God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Just hopping on here on this wonderful rainy day. And, you know, just wanted to encourage somebody today because a lot of people, they look at the rain and their entire day is affected by it. And so we have to change our perspective. That's what God has been working with me on. It's not always what things look like, but it's more of your perspective on it. How do you respond to it? And that's something really good that my pastor always says, is that, you know, when you get to heaven, God is not going to judge you on what they or what something did to you, you know, i.e. the rain, how it makes you gloomy. He's going to judge you on how you responded to that rain, or how you responded to that person who told you off and, you know, really offended you in the worst way. And so it's really about responsibility. Nobody wants responsibility. It's like we grow up and everybody's still always looking for who to blame about what goes on in your life. What is that, dandruff? You know, what's going on in your life. And it literally is true that life is what you make it. Now, you know, we, of course, it's inevitable that we're going to have all kind of trials and all kind of, you know, craziness thrown our way. And it's only because God gives, you know, the toughest battles to his strongest soldiers. You know, he know you can handle it. He's not going to put more on you than you can bear. That is not scriptural, by the way. It's scriptural, but it's just not the right scripture. You know, a lot of people use that God's not going to put more on you than you can bear. But, I mean, he will not tempt you or test you to an extent of a trial that you cannot handle. You can handle it. You are, without a doubt, more than a conqueror. And it's just so important that you get that in your soul, get that in your mind, get that in your heart, that what God says about you is true. And your breakthrough is right on the other side of you pressing towards the goal, pressing through the trial. You know, a lot of people faint, you know, give up. That was Bible study last night, 2 Corinthians chapter 4. And my God, what a meaty, oh, such good food. When you yearning for God's word and answers to your life, which is in God's word, everybody's yearning for answers. Everybody's yearning for that space to, in your heart and in your life, to be at peace and to be able to handle everything and anything, and what you can, with the word of God and with Christ as the center and head of your life. I mean, it's just night and day when you think you got to handle everything on your own, as I did growing up as an independent woman. Like my mother, she's always been independent, always been my father, you too, which, you know, that's not biblical, so we gonna go ahead and cancel that. But she was just as strong, and I didn't miss having both parents because she was so strong and, you know, able to handle it. And I had that independence from her, which is something that, you know, when you grow up independent, you gotta eventually shed that off and know that you are dependent on the Most High God, and which will show you your also to be dependent on your husband. And, you know, always go to God for yourself. Be independent in that only. And but it's just, you know, it's just amazing you know, the difference between knowing that you could trust him to take care of everything, and he's always going to see you through. Like, nothing can happen that God isn't going to see you through, not pull you out of, because he wants you to grow. He wants us to be strong enough to handle the next trial and all the attempts that the enemy tries to throw at us. But stay steadfast and believing, and know that you got a big God that is on your side, that is rooting you on, that is has that peace waiting for you to step into, to persevere and not faint, and be strong enough to stand, have faith enough to know that greater is coming. He ain't brought you this far to leave you where you at, period. Like, he's not going to do that to his children and who he loved and who he sent his only son to die for. He's not going to leave you hanging like that when you know that you can depend on him. Now, if you want to do your own thing and you so independent, and I'm not going to believe in what the big God, the father of the universe, the creator who created my life to go a specific way, I'm not going to believe in what he says, you know, then that's when you open up that can of worms for your life to devour you. Your flesh to devour you, the enemy seeking whom he may devour, because he's just waiting for those, you know, intellects and those people who try to act like they don't need God, who created you. Is ridiculous. Did you create yourself? But anyways, we gotta, you know, snap out of it, know that we can have peace through the storm and everything that's going on in our on the news, and you know, on the next street over. My God, we hear gunshots in my neighborhood every night, and I praise God that my children, they're not afraid of that. They don't have to fear, because we know that we serve God and he is going to protect us. He keeps some angels encamped around us, and we live our life for him, which is good. It's nothing that's not going to benefit you. It's not anything that's not going to profit you when you serve the Lord. He is so wonderful and so worthy to be praised. And so, you know, that's just a huge testimony, that 1,000 might fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near you. It won't come near you. That is his promise. You got to believe this. You have to believe this. It's so sad that we miss out on our promises and the things that God has for us and the breakthroughs and, you know, the blessings, because we don't believe nothing. We've been so bamboozled all of our lives, you know, being around people who we can't believe, and being, you know, classmates and, you know, anybody that's done us wrong, that's told you lies, and, you know, it makes it hard to believe in a God that you can't see, but he is real. And when you seek him, you will find that truth. And I just want to encourage you today, just keep seeking God. Keep seeking the truth of Jesus Christ, Christ the King, who is the resurrected one that lives in you. You can resurrect and bounce back off of anything in this earth when you have the Holy Spirit, the Son of the living God, Christ the King, living in you. There is nothing that you can't handle. And that is an amazing rest to just know that. I can't stress it enough. That's my encouraging words for today. God is so good. Please seek him with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul. And love him, because he loves you so much, and his arms is wide open waiting for you to repent from your old ways, from your yesterday. Nobody's better than nobody. I'm repenting every day for anything that was known, that was unknown. We have to get ourselves right with him, and we can do that because he's forgiven us already. We just got to step into the forgiveness and stop stepping away from him because of our past and what we've done, and not thinking that we're forgiven. And it's a change of life. So God bless you. I hope you stay encouraged. I hope that you seek God with all your heart, and know that he is rooting for you and he loves you, and I love you too. God bless you.